Today we are at the allotment and we're gonna do a quick tour. It's our new plot of land here in London, UK. I'm gonna show you what we did since we got this back in August. We had weeds and grass growing as tall as my chest. We managed to clear it out with some volunteers. Added loads of features. It's still not done, but we did a lot of things. So if we start walking at the entrance, we got two round raised beds that we filled up with a mix of compost and soil that was already here. Luckily, the soil is really full of nutritious and microorganisms. We use a technique called Three Sisters, which involves planting pumpkins, corn, and beans in the same space, and they all cooperate with each other. And we added some mulch, straw mulch, to retain the moisture, as we're not always here to water, so that helps quite a lot. Around those, we have loads of flowers that we planted from seeds in the ground. At the entrance, we created a pathway using logs that were already here, so we reused materials that were here. It's super simple. We just added soil around some flat logs. It just makes a good entrance with flowers around, but also edible plants like chard and marigolds, geraniums, and so many other things. And then behind me, we actually got the centerpiece of this whole plot of land, which is the pond. That was extremely easy to make. We used an old oak barrel. It's into the ground, topped up with water, added a few features like bricks, aquatic plants like duckweed, iris that were already here but can actually be transplanted into water, and a small solar-powered pump that pumps the water. And it's a really cool feature along this massive plant of lavender that was already here and we decided to keep, because when it's in full flower, it's an actual showstopper. It's absolutely amazing for so many things. You can use the flowers to make oil, tinctures. And then on side of me, the first two things that you see are two raised beds with an extra extension with a few flowers planted up, but also borage at the beginning and at the end of the first raised bed with a structure made with bamboo to have climbing beans all over it by the time we get to July. In the middle there are a combination of onions and shallots, but also courgettes that are now producing and we can pick up small as they keep producing at different times throughout the summer. And then we have another raised bed here, which is for now purely corn, but then we plan to add probably beans, eventually pumpkins, just at the beginning and at the end. So again, to replicate the three sister methods. And behind me there is a shed that was in a pretty bad shape. We painted the inside and the outside, we fixed some shelvings inside, and now it's perfectly working. And then there is a closed area to the shed which we use as a sitting area. We're going to install a vertical garden, but also we use it to sow seeds. Behind me again there is a round raised bed that we made using some bricks that we found here. That was absolutely easy to make. We created a teepee using bamboo. So you basically plant bamboos in circle and then you join the top part. So then you create a structure for beans to climb up. And we also added two cabbage, which are looking great. And the system that we used here is cardboard at the bottom, topped up with compost, and you can start growing straight away with a no-dig system. And then we use the rest of the bricks to create a nice border all around the side of the plot of land, which has a variety of loads of different things, including flowers like rose hips, but also an old rosemary plant that was already here, geraniums, marigolds, that will create a nice border to attract even more pollinators to the area. Behind me, we created an area not long ago using some raised beds, metal raised beds that we installed and sent by a company that sent us quite a few, and contrary to the common opinion, they are actually super cold, so they don't warm up with the sun. They retain moisture and they're doing a great job. We planted tomatoes, carrots, asparagus, but also we have beetroots here. On a few plants like beans, actually, we are having a few pests like black flies, or on broad beans, but I'm not really worried. So I'm not gonna use any sort of chemical. We have loads of ladybird larvae, but also actual ladybird going around and eating them. So it's a natural pest control. If you create the right conditions, you don't have to do anything else. Then we have some nice wood chips on the ground. We place them to repel weeds. And I must say it helps so much to place cardboard as well under the wood chips. And then in the middle, this was meant to be an herb spiral, but then we converted it into something a bit different. There is a dahlia in the middle that is about to flower. And then there are three courgette plants producing small courgettes and flowers that we can already pick up, and spinach. But we also interplanted beetroot. So by the time the spinach bolts during the summer, which means goes into flower, then we can remove them slowly and leave space to the beetroots to grow and have this succession planting and constant production of food. And then these last two raised beds are potatoes, a few different varieties, but we also kept a few plants that we found here, like comfrey. As you can see, there is comfrey in a few different spots, and it's great for many reasons. First of all, it produces flowers, which attracts lots of different insects, but at the same time, the plant has a long taproot, so it draws minerals that normally are not available for the other plants. So if you chop it down, add it into a sock, and submerge it in water, you slowly release fertilizer. It's a free source of fertilizer that you can use in any growing space. And now we're gonna move to the other side, and I'm gonna show you the rest of the allotment. So now we are on the other side of the allotment, plot of land. We also have a raised bed here with a variety of different things like pak choi, mizuna, mustard, and chilies. But also I recently planted peas, so we created another structure that will help the peas to climb up and have an extra production on the side. And then we have a two-bay composting system that we created as soon as we arrived here to get rid of all the weeds that were here. Then again here another comfrey, and a huge massive plant of rhubarb that was already here that we cleared up because it was taking up so much space, and now we made it smaller. And then we recently created two raised beds that are now planted up with lots of different things like aubergines, courgettes, cucumbers, chilies, but also brassicas like broccoli in the middle and cabbage around the borders. And I topped it up with homemade compost that I made in my backyard. We built another small raised bed here on the side just because we had an extra space, and we planted up some tomatoes and one or two varieties from Turkey, kindly gifted. Apparently she said she's been growing this variety for 15 years and they're massive tomatoes. I can't wait to have them. And then if we enter into the polytunnel, we planted up loads of different things. Even in here we have cucumbers on that side with aubergine, but also marigolds along the borders, chilies, all in the same raised bed. And I also planted some seeds that are soon coming up with more cucumbers to have this succession of food. And then in the middle raised bed we have melons. One is a grafted variety that is now picking up, and another one is honeydew melons. And then we have also here on this side a few different varieties of tomatoes interplanted with basil, which is a companion plant, and marigold. The marigold were planted 2 or 3 weeks in advance of the tomatoes, so they have a symbiotic function, helping with some varieties of nematodes that could potentially damage the roots of the tomatoes. And if we walk out of here, as you can see, it's pretty into the ground because we digged a 3 by 3 meter hole, half a meter deep, to host this polytunnel, because we didn't want to shade the area on the side, but also we needed soil to top up the raised beds around the garden. And then if we walk down this way, we have planted loads of sunflowers along the border that hopefully will come up soon, and we created another structure for a few varieties of beans that I've got a seed library a few years ago. They're an amazing variety that I can't wait to show. And yeah, everything seems thriving so good, even if it's just a few months that we did all this. And the reason is because we didn't disturb too much the microorganisms in the soil, and we are trying to encourage wildlife and insects into the area to hopefully mimic nature at a level that we will have like an amazing production of food. So I hope you enjoyed this tour. I'm gonna do more throughout the summer, and I'm gonna show you how we are getting on with the food production in this 10 by 11 plot of land in the middle of London.